If you'd like to grow a pepper that thrives in the heat, produces mass amounts of peppers, and that isn't spicy, be sure to stick around for this video because I'm going to be sharing all about the Shishito pepper. I'm Audrey from Audrey's Little Farm, and around here it's all about finding joy in the simple things. Have you ever went to dinner somewhere and had somebody that cooked peppers that just looked delicious and amazing, and they tell you, oh, they're not that hot, don't worry, but then you try them and your mouth's on fire? I'm sure you have. We've all had it happen to us, and so I pretty much shy away from peppers anywhere I go because I'm always afraid it's going to be too hot. Until this last year, I finally got the nerve up to try one of these peppers, and oh my goodness, where has the Shishito pepper been my whole life? It is my now favorite pepper to plant, super mild, and it produces like madness. So here's the Shishito pepper. Okay, so this is my Shishito pepper plant, and it's just a baby plant, as you can kind of see, and it already has a ton of peppers. They're like small, slender, kind of wrinkly green peppers. And I have a whole entire row right here, and they're already producing like crazy. Okay, so if you'd like to plant Shishitos for the first time, plant them in full sun, keep the soil consistently moist, don't let it get waterlogged, but don't let it dry out between waterings, and then harvest your peppers frequently. They're best harvested when they're smaller, because the bigger they get a little bit tough. And so as soon as they're a couple inches long, you can harvest them. Okay, so if you aren't yet convinced to plant your own Shishitos, at least go to the store and buy some. They're super mild. They're great for fresh eating, pickling, stir frying. And if you'd like to know the best way to cook them, come to my next video because I will be sharing my most favorite recipe.